Okay, so yung first problem is we are going to prove tangent beta plus 45 degrees plus tangent beta minus 45 degrees equals 2 tangent squared, or rather 2 tangent 2 beta. So alam naman natin dyan na yung tangent 45 is equal to 1, di ba? Kasi nga, alam natin na yung value ng sine 45 is equal to square root of 2 over 2. Then, yung cosine 45 is equal to square root of 2 over 2. And then, yung tangent, di ba? Tangent 45. That is sine 45 all over cosine 45. Which is equal to square root of 2 over 2 divided by square root of 2 over 2. Kaya, ang sagot is 1. Also, you can use your calculator naman to find the value of tangent 45, which is 1. Okay, so to prove this identity, we are going to manipulate first the left-hand side. So, let us first consider the left-hand side of the equation. Alright, so how we are going to do this? So, tangent beta plus 45 degrees. So, diba meron tayong identity na tangent A plus B is equal to 1, or rather tangent A plus tangent B divided by 1 minus tangent A times tangent B. So, yan yung gagamitin natin dyan. Kapag naman minus tangent A minus B, so ito tangent A minus tangent B all over 1 plus tangent A plus times tangent B. So, let us solve. So, we have tangent beta plus 45. I-apply lang natin ito. So, kumbaga, yung beta mo is yung A, yung 45 yun yung B. So, that becomes tangent A, so yun yung beta, plus tangent B, yun yung 45. Tangent 45 plus tangent 45 divided by 1 minus tangent beta times tangent 45 degrees. Okay. Plus. Ito naman. So, instead na plus, so yung minus naman. So, we have tangent beta minus tangent 45 all over 1 plus tangent beta tangent 45 degrees. Simplify lang. So, we have tangent beta plus. So, what is the value of tangent 45? 1. So, that is 1 divided by 1 minus tangent beta times tangent 45 is 1 plus tangent beta minus tangent 45 is also 1. Then, 1 plus tangent of beta times 1. Okay. Then, simplify lang yan. That becomes tangent beta plus 1 over 1. Tangent beta times 1 is tangent beta. Then, plus tangent beta minus 1 all over 1. Tangent beta times 1, that is tangent beta. Then, combine lang natin. So, alam natin ang LCD niyan ay... Sige, solve natin yan. Ang LCD niya is the product of this. Pwede natin gawin mo ng 1 minus tangent beta times 1 plus tangent beta. So, 1 minus tangent beta times 1 plus tangent beta divided by 1 minus tangent beta. So, that is 1 plus tangent beta. So, tangent beta plus 1 times 1 plus tangent beta. So, FOIL method lang. Tangent beta times 1. So, tangent beta. So, tangent beta times tangent beta, that is positive. Tangent squared beta, the inner. 1 times 1, so plus 1. The outside, 1, or the last term rather. 1 times tangent beta is tangent beta. So, yan yun. Plus... 1 minus tangent beta times 1 plus tangent beta divided by 1 plus tangent beta. So, matitira 1 minus tangent beta. So, i-close natin to. That becomes tangent beta minus 1 times 1 minus tangent beta. So, first term, tangent beta times 1. So, tangent beta. Then, outer, tangent beta times negative tangent beta. So, negative tangent squared beta. Then, inner, negative 1 times 1, negative 1. Then, last term, negative 1 times negative tangent, positive tangent beta. Makikita nyo, may mga similar terms na pwedeng makancel dyan. So, like, tangent beta, tangent squared beta minus tangent squared beta, 0. This will be cancelled. 1 minus 1, cancel. Okay, so, matitira dito is tangent beta plus tangent beta is 2 tangent beta plus tangent beta is 3 tangent beta plus tangent beta is 4 tangent beta. So, we have 4 tangent beta. Then, ito, pwede nyo yung i-multiply sum and difference of 2 binomials. So, 1 times 1, 1, negative tan times positive tan, negative tangent squared beta. So, ito yung ating left-hand side. Yung simplified form ng left-hand side. So, para ma-prove nating identity siya, dapat yung right-hand side, ito din yung maging value niya pag na-simplify natin. So, let's solve the right-hand side. Okay, the right-hand side will be, the expression is 2 tangent 2 beta. Okay, so, ang gagamitin lang naman natin dito ay yung yung double angle formula, that is tangent 2A is equal to 2 tangent A all over 1 minus tangent squared A. Ito yung formula ang gagamitin natin. So, ang A dyan ay yung beta sa given. So, isolve natin. So, apply lang natin dito. So, we have, nalabas natin yung 2. 2 times, what is the value of tangent 2 beta? So, we'll apply this. That becomes 2 times tangent, what is our A? So, that is beta divided by 1 minus tangent squared beta. Multiply lang, 2 times 2, 4 tangent beta all over 1 minus tangent squared beta. So, ayan, makikita na ninyo, equal talaga yung left-hand side at saka yung right-hand side. 4 tangent beta over 1 minus tangent squared beta. Same din lang dito. Okay, so, na-prove na natin na yung first ay identity. Okay? Okay, yung susunod naman is tangent alpha minus 180 degrees equals tangent alpha. So, ano lang naman to? Ang dapat una nating malaman is the value of tangent 180 degrees. So, di ba ang tangent 180 is equal to 0? Bakit? Kasi ang sine 180 is equal to 0, then cosine 180 is negative 1. So, di ba ang tangent tangent 180 is equal to sine of 180 degrees divided by cosine 180 degrees. So, sine over cosine. So, yan yun. Yan ang value ng tangent 0 divided by negative 1. That is 0. So, yun din. Pwede kayo lang naman kayo mag-calculator. Tangent 180 equals 0. Then, gamitin lang natin yung difference of tangents. So, that will be the value of tangent alpha minus 180 is equal to tangent alpha minus tangent 180 degrees divided by 1 plus tangent alpha times tangent 180 degrees. So, we have tangent alpha, then tangent 180 is 0 divided by 1 plus tangent alpha times tangent 180 times 0. Pag sinimplify, tangent alpha minus 0, so that is tangent alpha. divided by tangent alpha times 0, it is 0 plus 1, 1. So, tangent divided 1, tangent alpha. So, makikita nyo, equal siya dun sa nasa right hand side. Equal sila. So, yun. So, ganun lang i-prove yung tangent alpha minus 180 equals tangent alpha. So, ganun lang siya mag-prove.